Good morning, children. Today we are going to learn an interesting lesson about a great person of India. He was a president, like 11th president of India, and he worked as a scientist. He is well known as Missile Man of India. So I think you got the idea who is called as Missile Man of India. So, and also worked as a president of India. Who is that? He is none other than the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, so here you have given some pictures. You have to identify the names of these persons. So their names have been given in the help box. With the help of this box, you can write the names of these persons. Who is the first person? Who is the first one? Yes, APJ Abdul Kalam, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Who is he? So on September 5th, every year, we celebrate Teacher's Day on the occasion of birthday of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan Garu. So who is he? He is Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. Then, so you can see here, he is the present president of India. He said Ramnath Kovind. Ramnath Kovind. And you can see here, he is the present first president of India. First president of India. Who is that? Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Which is Dr. Rajendra Prasad. Please write the names of these persons, the box given to you. Now we go to the lesson. So in this lesson, we have given a boy named Arjun. So one day he goes to the school. So when he is in the classroom, his teacher asked him to read the lesson. Then he started reading the lesson about the Abdul Kalam. Okay, now we'll see the lesson. Arjun picked up his bag and ran down the winding road on his way to school. He heard the school bell ring and said to himself, "There goes the school bell. It is welcoming me." As he ran in, the jiggles and chatters of other children greeted him. He entered the classroom and sat on a seat near the window, his favorite corner. He took out his book and the class teacher entered. Good morning, Mom, greeted the students. She smiled and looked around. Good morning, dear children. Today, we will learn about a very famous person who was also the president of our country. So, look at these pictures and let me see how many of you can guess his name. All the students shouted, "APJ Abdul Kalam." "Yes," she said. Okay, children, we'll see the first para first. What is that? Who is that? What is the name of the boy? Arjun. What did he do? He picked up his bag and ran down the winding road in his way to school. Winding road means what? A road which has many curves. The road which has many curves, that is called a winding road. Okay. When he was coming to school, what did he hear? He heard the school bell. The sound of the school bell. Okay. When he heard the school bell ring, he said himself that the school bell is welcoming him. He said himself that the school bell is welcoming him. As he was entering into the school, so he heard the jiggles and the chatters of the other children greeted him. He felt that jiggle means a big laugh, a loud laugh of the children, and chatters of them means chit chat of the children greeted him. He felt like that the big loud laugh and a chit chat of the children greeted him. Then he entered into the classroom and he sat near the window, which is very favorite place to him. Okay, which is very favorite to him. So it is in the corner of a classroom. So then after sitting in his place, he took out the book from the bag. After that, his class teacher entered into the class. What do you do when the class teacher enters into the class? What do you do first? You'll say, "Good morning, ma'am." Like that you say, no? Same way, these children also said or wished the teacher, "Good morning, ma'am." Like that they wished the teacher. Okay, when the children wish like this, what your teacher do? She smiles, is it not? Same way, this teacher also smiled at the students and looked around the class. And after that, she also wished the students good morning, children. Then after that, she said to the children, "Today we are going to learn about a famous person who was also the president of India." Then after that, she showed some pictures of the great persons of India and asked the students to identify that. And she showed the picture of a great person who worked as a president of India and asked the students to say the name of that person. Then all the children, they shouted. If you know the answer, how do you shout in the class? Yes, like that, the students in the class also shouted, "Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam." Okay, like that they shouted. Then after that, Arjun, like others, opened his book and waited. He had started coming to school after a gap of 1 year. Okay, like other students, what did he do, this Arjun? Arjun also opened his book and waiting. So, is he continuing his schooling? No, he had the gap. He had the 1 year gap. Understand? So Arjun had 1 year gap. Why he had the gap? So because we'll see the reason here. After his father's death in the city, it was not possible for his mother to send him to school. Okay, what happened? 1 year before, his father died. So that was the reason it was not possible to his mother to send him to the school. So it was very difficult to them to lead their life in the city after his father's death. So that was the reason what happened. they shifted to their village and she started working in the fields to earn a living. Okay. So after the death of his father, they shifted to their village. So to lead their life. So Arjun's mother, what she was doing? She started working as the agricultural laborer. Okay. She was going to the fields, working as a daily wage laborer. Roju kooli pani, vyavasaya bhoomilo vere valla paniki kooli paniki velledanamata. Arjun wanted to become a police officer, but his dream was shattered. Life went on for him until one morning when he saw a big board at the village crossing. You understand? When his father was alive, what was his dream? His dream was to become a police officer. He wanted to become a police officer. But after the death of his father, his dream was shattered, or his dream was destroyed. His dream was damaged. Okay. Then his life went on like that. Until one morning when he saw a big board at the village crossing. What do you mean by crossing? A place where two roads cross. It is called a crossing. What was the board there? We'll see. The villagers had gathered around it and were discussing in excited voices. They said that a big industrialist was setting up a school for the children of 10 surrounding villages. So around that board, the villagers, they had gathered and were discussing about how they were discussing. They were discussing in excited voices, very joyful voices they were discussing. What was the discussion taking place there? About what they were discussing? They were discussing about a school which was going to be established by an industrialist, and which was going to start, or which was going to become functional within few months. Okay, the gathering was discussing about a school which was going to be established by an industrialist, which was going to give the education for the children of 10 surrounding villages. Understand? All the children would be provided education, books and uniform free of cost. It was truly a blessing for many. Within months, the school was functional and Arjun was very happy to resume his studies. His mother got a helper's job in the same school. Okay. This school was providing the education, uniform and books free of cost. Without any fees, this school was going to give them free education, free books, free uniform. So this school was going to functional within few months. Arjun's mother also got After it was started, Arjun mother got job in that school as a helper. Then Arjun, can you read the lesson for us? Said the teacher. He confidently replied, "Yes, ma'am." He read loud. Aul Paki Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam. So when his teacher, Arjun's teacher, asked him, "Arjun, can you read this lesson for us?" When teacher asked him like that, then Arjun confidently, what did he say? He said, "Yes, ma'am." Okay, he said, "Yes, ma'am, I can read," like that he said, and started reading. So how did he read? He read very loudly. He read aloud, "Aul Paki Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam," popularly known as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, is an Indian scientist who was also the 11th President of India. He started reading about whom? He started reading about the Aul Paki Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam. Means APJ Abdul Kalam. If anybody asks you, what is the full name of APJ Abdul Kalam? You should say, what is that? Aul Paki Jainulabdin Abdul Kalam. You should remember, okay? So he was popularly known as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. He was the 11th President of India, and also he was a famous scientist. So when was he born? He was born on 15th October 1931 at Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu in South India. When was he born? Abdul Kalam was born on 15th October 1931. Where was he born? He was born in Rameshwaram. He was born at Rameshwaram in Tamil Nadu in South India. So if you see the name of his father, Jainulabdin. What was the father's name of Abdul Kalam? Abdul Kalam's father name was Jainulabdin. Okay? His father, Jainulabdin, was a boat owner, and his mother, Ashaima, was a housewife. Okay? His father was a boat owner and his mother was a housewife. What was the name of the Abdul Kalam's father? Jainulabdin. What was the mother's name? Ashaima. What was the name of the Abdul Kalam's mother? Ashaima. She was a housewife. He came from a poor family and started to work at a very early age to earn money for his family members. Okay. So you are also coming to school, is it? But do any work at home? Is any work assigned to you in the morning? No. So but here you see that Abdul Kalam's family is very poor family. So that was the reason he was assigned a work. Okay, he was given a work. Before going to school, he used to do some work for his family. Okay, his family was very poor family. Whatever the money earned by his father is not enough to lead his family members or his family. So that was the reason before he goes to school, Abdul Kalam used to work. Okay. He loved his family. He scored average marks in school, but he was very hardworking and intelligent. He spent hours studying, especially mathematics. Before school, Kalam distributed newspaper to earn money. He was very intelligent. Okay, when he was in school, he used to get very average marks. But he was very interested at maths, so he spent hours for studying mathematics. Before going to school, I told you, before going to school, he used to do some work. What was the work he used to do? Kalam distributed newspaper to earn money. He loved his family. So that was the reason he wanted to help his family. So he distributed newspaper to earn the money for his family. So before going to school. Okay. School ki velle mundu poddune em chesevanta paper boy ga pan chesadanamanta ante illillu tirugutu morning paper vesi tarvata school ku vachevadu anamata Abdul Kalam. Meeku atlanti baadha emi ledhu kada. So vaalla family chaala పేద కుటుంబం కాబట్టి ఆయన అట్లా పనిచేశాడు కానీ మీకు మీ పేరెంట్స్ ఏది కావాలో అది ఇస్తున్నారు కదా సో యు హావ్ టు స్టడీ వెల్ హీ స్టడీడ్ అట్ రామేశ్వరం ఎలిమెంటరీ స్కూల్ వన్స్ అబ్దుల్ కలాం కంప్లీటెడ్ స్కూల్ హీ వెంట్ టు సెయింట్ జోసెఫ్స్ కాలేజ్ తిరుచునాపల్లి affiliated to the University of Madras. Okay. Elementary, where did he complete his school? Elementary school in Rameshwaram. He studied in Rameshwaram Elementary School. Once he completed his studies there, where did he go? He went to the St. Joseph's College. So after completion of his education in Rameshwaram, where did he go? He went to the St. Joseph's College. Where is it? In Tiruchinapalli. This college was affiliated to the which university? Madras University. He graduated in physics in 1954 and moved to Madras in 1955 to study aerospace engineering. Okay, he completed his graduation in physics. What do you mean by graduation? Completed graduation means he successfully completed his degree. Okay, he completed his academic degree. Okay, academic degree is graduation. Okay, and in which year? In 1954. In which subject? In physics. After completion of that, he went to where? He went to Madras. In which year? In 1955. For what he went to Madras? To study aerospace engineering. Okay, he wanted to study aerospace engineering. It is a course. It is an engineering course. Aerospace engineering means it is an engineering course to study about the aircraft and space. It is an engineering course to study about the aircraft and space vehicles. Once the Dean was not happy with his work and wanted him to complete his project in 2 days' time. Abdul Kalam worked very hard and completed his project on time to the dean's surprise. So the dean, head of his engineering course, okay, head of his department is called the dean. So once he gave the project work to him, okay, once his dean gave him a project to work, but that work was not satisfactory. So then Isuddin said, he asked Abdul Kalam to complete that within 2 days. So your teachers also give you some projects. Even your teachers give 10 days, 15 days time, you don't complete, is it? But so to the Abdul Kalam, his dean gave only 2 days time. Then he did very well. He did that project very well. Then by seeing his project, Abdul Kalam's dean got surprised. Abdul Kalam's dean got surprised. Then after graduating from the Madras Institute of Technology in 1960, Kalam worked as an aerospace engineer at Defense Research and Development Organization and later with the Indian Space Research Organization. So he completed his graduation from the Madras Institute of Technology 1960. After completion of his graduation, he worked as a space engineer. Where did he work as a space engineer? In DRDO. In DRDO. What do you mean by DRDO? Defense Research and Development Organization. You should remember, DRDO means Defense Research and Development Organization. And after that, he worked with the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO. Okay, ISRO, Indian Space Research Organization. So in that ISRO, Abdul Kalam was the director of India's first indigenous satellite launch vehicle, which launched a satellite called Rohini in July 1980. Okay, so in ISRO, he worked as a project director. Okay, he worked as a project director of India's first indigenous satellite launch vehicle. Okay, indigenous means originating in particular place, means which is belong to a particular place, that is called the indigenous. Okay, so he was worked as a project director of India's first indigenous satellite launch vehicle, which launched the satellite called Rohini in July 1980. SLV means satellite launching vehicle. Okay, satellite launching vehicle. Okay, satellite launch vehicle. So పూర్తి స్వదేశీ పరిజ్ఞానంతో తయారు చేయబడినటువంటి సాటిలైట్ లాంచ్ వెహికల్. సో దీనికి ఈయన డైరెక్టర్ గా వ్యవహరించడం జరిగింది. దీస్ సాటిలైట్ లాంచ్ ది రోహిణి ఇన్ జులై. ఇట్ ఇస్ ది సాటిలైట్ ఇట్ లాంచ్ ది సాటిలైట్ కాల్డ్ ది Rohini in July 1980. He is called the Missile Man of India. Abdul Kalam is also called the Missile Man of India. He also played an important role in India's Pokhran second nuclear test in 1998. Okay. So Pokhran second nuclear test. Our India conducted nuclear test 2 times. So in the second one, he played important role. Abdul Kalam was elected the President of India in 2002. He was a visiting professor at Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, and Indian Institute of Management, Indore. Okay, he was elected as a President of India in 2002. So, though he was the President of India, because of his love at students, he worked as a professor, visiting professor at Indian Institute of Management, Ahmedabad, and Indian Institute of Management, Indore. He was also the Chancellor of the Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology. He was also the Chancellor, means the head of the university is called the Chancellor. He also worked as a Chancellor of the Indian Institute of Space and Technology, where Thiruvananthapuram. He was also involved in various other educational institutions. Not only that, he worked in other different educational institutions. He had written many famous books like India 2020, A Vision for the New Millennium, Ignited Minds, Wings of Fire, and Mission India 2020. Like this, he wrote many books. Okay, once again we see the books written by the Abdul Kalam. India 2020, A Vision for the New Millennium, Ignited Minds, Wings of Fire, and Mission India 2020. Abdul Kalam loves the youth and children. He always felt happy to meet them. Okay. He loves youth and children. So that was the reason he always wants to be with the children, with the students. He died at the age of 83 on 27th July 2015. While addressing the students of IIM Shillong, Meghalaya. Okay, Indian Institute of Management. IIM means Indian Institute of Management. So when he was addressing, means when he was giving speech or speaking to the students of Indian Institute of Management, Shillong, on 27th July 2015, unfortunately, he died. The teacher said, "Good reading, Arjun. I am so proud of you. Let us all clap for him." So then, after this, he completed the lesson reading. Arjun completed the lesson reading. Then he completed, his teacher appreciated him. If you read well, your teacher also, "Oh, very nice reading. She appreciates you, is it?" So, and she asked all the other students to clap for you. Same as the teacher also did in the class. So, by seeing the reading of the Arjun, she asked all the children in the class to clap for him. The children clapped loudly, but Arjun was lost in thoughts. On his way back from school, he was quiet. At night, he told his mother, "Mom, I want to become a scientist like Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam." Then she smiled and hugged him. "What does that mean? But I am sure you will do well." Arjun felt happy. Okay. So when all the his teacher appreciated and all his friends clapped at him after the school, he was very quiet. He went home very quietly. And after going to home, he said to his mother, "Mom, I want to become a scientist like Abdul Kalam." Then his mother took him near and hugged him and gave a smile. So then what is the meaning of that? That means, sir, my son, you can do it. Okay, children. So I hope you understood this lesson. So we'll see all the question answers and grammar part in the next class. Until then, have a nice day. Bye-bye.